Let's take a look at an example of doing a proof by induction. So we have the following: prove that n is greater than or equal to 1, and we have, when this is true, when n is greater than or equal to 1, that 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way to n is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. We want to prove that. First, you're going to need to check the base case. What does that mean? That basically means you set n equal to the value of 1. So on the left side, you're going to end up with 1. Why is there a 1 on the left side above my head? Because back in this formula, you no longer have the 2 and the 3. All you have is just that first 1, and that's it. It's just n equals 1. You don't have any additional terms. So that's why here above my head there, it's 1 exactly. Then after that, on the right side, you have to do the same thing exactly. So n has to be replaced with 1 wherever n occurs. So here it's going to be the 1 in front times the 1 plus 1 over 2. Work that out a little bit, right? So it's 1 plus 1, which is 2. 2 over 2 is 1. So notice the following, that when n has the value 1, the left side, that means 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way to n. But when n has the value 1, that is 1, that is equal to the value of that formula on the right side, which is also equal to 1. That's what it means to say that the base case checks when n has the value 1. So now what we're going to do is basically assume that this same formula, 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way up to n, will be true for some value of n. We don't know what the value of n is, but we're going to assume that this is true. Why are we assuming that? That's a good case. That's a good question, rather. Well, what you could do is go back here and try that same formula, for example, for n equals 2, if you worked it out. And then if you could try it for n equals 3. And it would seem to suggest that this is actually correct. In other words, we can conclude on that, that this formula above my head actually works. So as long as you believe that this works for some value of n, then after that, you can use it to prove that it works for n plus 1. What does that mean? So above my head, you see this expression that says 1 plus 2 plus 3, and then plus and dot, 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 all the way up to n. So what you do is this first part above my head, that represents this, n times n plus 1 over 2. And then you're going to add n plus 1 to it. So that's exactly what this note says. Use this to prove it's true for n plus 1 by adding n plus 1 to 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way up to n. You see? That is what you need. So let's work this out. This part above my head, that can be replaced with n times n plus 1 over 2. Where is that coming from? Again, this is because up here, back at step 2, we assume that the two sides are equal, so they can be used to replace each other. So replace this, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n, with n times n plus 1 over 2. Keep that n plus 1 attached. After that, it's just really algebra, and that's it. So we write the n plus 1 as 2 times n plus 1 over 2. Continue. Place everything over a single denominator. So that's why it looks like this. N times n plus 1 plus 2 times n plus 1 over 2. Next. So distribute this n over to that n that's going to give you n squared. Distribute that n over to the 1 that's going to give you n. Distribute the 2 to the n that's going to give you 2n. Distribute the 2 to the 1 that's going to give you 2. Now, n and 2n in the middle can be combined to get 3n in the middle at this next step above my head. So you have n squared plus 3n plus 2 over 2. And the last step is to factor the top. So you need two numbers that multiply to positive 2, that constant at the end. Same two numbers have to add up to positive 3. So when I do that, down below me, as you can see, I get the following results. So I get n plus 2, multiply again plus 1. The reason is I get 1 times 2, will give you that 2 constant at the end. And then 1 plus 2 will give you that 3, which is the coefficient on the end, at above my head. So now we have this in factored form, and this basically proves that our formula works for n plus 1 also. Why is that the case? It's not obvious just by looking at this last step, to be honest. Well, the reason is, you see, this is n plus 1. So go back to the top, all the way to the top. You see, right there, the formula. At first, all you have is n, right above my head. You just have n. But now with this new one, what you have above my head is n plus 1 at the bottom. So n has been replaced with n plus 1. Go up here. You see above my head, it says n plus 1 within parentheses. So down below here, now we have n plus 2. Well, what does that tell us? It tells us that n has been replaced with essentially n plus 1. Why is that the case? Think about this. Go back here for a second. Right? Replace within the parentheses n with n plus 1. That would be n plus 1 plus 1, which would give you n plus 2. That's the same as having n plus 2 at that position, pretty much, you see? So that's why we conclude that this actually proves what we set out to prove. That's it for this one. Thanks so much. Please leave a like and subscribe. I'll see you in another video.